Elmonica Engineers, it is I, Mr. Nelson, your student manager, and I'm coming live once again on this special winter break assembly. Today is Friday, December 18th, 2020. Not a whole lot's changed in the world. I'm still here, you're still at home, but boy, do we have an assembly for you. Let's roll, engineers. Come on!
To the Republic, for which it stands,
one nation,
under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thanks so much, third grade team. Mrs. Maldivan, Mrs. Valentine, Mrs. Lee, that was great. Thanks for leading us in our Pledge of Allegiance. All right, engineers, we're switching gears. It's time for two of your favorite segments. First up is Mrs. Heatherly with an awesome rhythm activity. Take it away, Mrs. Heatherly.
Hi, Elmonica. This is Mrs. Heatherly. Today's activity is a rhythm activity. Surprise! Part of the problem with Mr. Grinch was that his heart was three sizes too small and there wasn't enough room for kindness towards others. So don't have your heart be too small. Don't be a Grinch. Give this a shot. Give it a try. You can clap along with these rhythms. Ta, to-o, ti-ti, rest. In music, we call those quarter note, half note, eighth notes, and a quarter rest. We've been practicing these in class. For an added challenge today, you could try to beatbox along with this rhythm activity. For each of the four music symbols, make a different sound that goes along with its length. Ta, to-o, ti-ti, and sh. You could change to sh. There are lots of different choices you could make. Give it a try and have fun. And don't forget, keep practicing.
Rhythm activity. And thanks all of you guys going along at home. I could hear so many more of you. Anyway, now it's our time for exercise of the week with Mr. S. So stand up, stretch, and let's get moving. Take it away, Mr. S.
Hi, engineers. Welcome to your math activity. You need your math journal, a pencil, sit down, and be quiet. Your lesson today is on probability. I have a bucket. There's four balls in there, red, green, yellow, and blue. If I don't look and I just reach in, what's the probability, the odds, the chances of pulling out a green ball? Well, there's four balls total. That's my denominator. How many green balls were there? One. So my probability, my odds of grabbing the green one are 1 in 4. Who can tell me what that is in a decimal? What's that? Say it again. You got it. I heard lots of you. Decimal, 25. How about a percent? 25%. You got it. Okay. You guys must have some pretty good math teachers out there. So then, hold on. Yeah? PE? I thought you said math. Well, why can't PUMPSALOT do it? Okay, fine. Good thing we're in the gym. All right, PE. So this game, lots of you are familiar with, it's called Lucky Color. The way it works is there are four colors. Before I spin, you choose which color. Green, yellow, blue, or red, you have a 25% chance of getting it right. I'm gonna spin. If you got the right color, you can just relax while the rest of us do the exercise. We're gonna work on a skill today. We're gonna work on basketball. So let's get started. All right, first spin, choose your color. Here we go. Green, if you got green, you can hydrate, relax. The rest of us are gonna do 10 jump shots. Here we go, 10 jump shots. Spin again. Choose your color before it stops. No switching. Blue. If you chose blue, chill, hydrate. The rest of us are going to do bounce passes. One for today. Here we go. Ooh, right on the line. We'll do it again real quick. Blue. Blue again. If you did not choose blue, we're going to do 10 rebounds. Jump up and get that ball. Are you hanging on the edge of your seat? All right, engineers, work hard in math, exercise every day. You'll have a strong body and mind. Take care of yourselves. See you soon.
Wow, Mr. S, that was awesome. Did you know that basketball is actually my favorite sport? Yeah, so those jump shots and those bounce passes were terrific. However, I don't know if calling out PUMPSALOT was a very good idea. It sure wasn't, brother. I talked to him and he doesn't like being called out like that. And, well, he himself is also a pretty good basketball player. And he said that once COVID passes, maybe you and Mr. PUMPSALOT could play a little one-on-one. And while you're thinking about it, he wants to show a little highlight reel. You guys, but if a one-on-one match did happen between Mr. S and Nelson PUMPSALOT, I'd have the popcorn ready to go. Anyway, I want to send it over to Miss All, who went out into the field and listen to you guys and everything that you're grateful for. Take it away, Miss Alt.
I just want to be grateful. I just want to be grateful. Yeah. I just want to show gratitude for everyone in my life. My mom and my dad and my sister are so nice. They influence me more than anyone in my life. I just want to be grateful.
Hi, I'm thankful for my brother and my family and my friends because they all help me a lot. And my brother is here.
I am thankful for my mommy.
I am grateful for a home.
I'm grateful for my baby brother because he always colors with me and he always plays with me.
I'm grateful for my house because in the pandemic I'm still okay and I can do my education properly.
I am grateful for my auntie to buy me the crew pack in Fortnite.
I am grateful for my parents and my family and myself because if my parents weren't here, I would not be alive. And they also helped me out on lots of stuff. They helped me out and they entertain me. They do lots of stuff with me. And yeah.
I'm thankful for Mr. Will, because I love him.
Air hug.
I am grateful for my books because I love to read books because I learned lots of new things.
Hi, I'm Henry, and this is my mom, and I'm thankful for my mom because she feeds me.
I'm thankful for you too.
I'm grateful for my health, and I'm grateful for my dancer thing. I'm the dancer.
I'm thankful for my family because my sister helps me with my math, and my dad helps me with my seesaw.
My name is Gautam, and my brother name's Jotam.
Hello.
And I am thankful to my brother because he makes me laugh every day.
I'm thankful for my stuffy because they're fluffy, and when I feel lonely, I can snuggle it and I feel all better.
Hi, I'm thankful for my blanket. So when I'm cold, it helps me. It makes me hot and cozy.
I'm thankful for my dog.
I'm grateful for me mom because she takes care of me.
I am thankful for my food that my family lets me eat. And I am thankful for my coloring book and my pencil so I can color beautiful things.
What are you grateful for?
I am great. One sec. Yeah.
I'm thankful for my dad because he is fun and lovable person. He gives this watch for my birthday.
Bye. See you.
Bye.
Bye, everyone.
I'm grateful when my mom cooks or when my dad grills, yeah. Or when my parents drive me in their automobiles. My attitude is gratitude, I'm on a different latitude. I love you, I'm not mad at you, you're awesome, I'll get back to you.
Engineers, that was awesome. Thanks so much for taking the time and showing and displaying who and what are some of the things you're grateful for. Next up is our January word of the month. And I think it's right up a lot of your guys' alleys. Take it away, Miss Kenyon and Miss Hastings.
Hello, Elmonica engineers. It's Mrs. Hastings and Mrs. Kenyon. And we're here to tell you about this month's word of the month. It is balanced.
What does it mean?
You are balanced when you know the importance of and can take care of your mind, body, and your feelings. Let's take a look at ways you can do that during remote learning.
You can take care of your mind by reading, creating or building something. You can make music or listen to music, organize your space or clean, draw or paint, write, or even meditate.
Here are some ways you can take care of your body. You can attend PE classes or try the assembly exercises from Mr. S. and Mrs. DeGandy. You can go for a walk or run. You can eat healthy food. You can try yoga. You can ride a bike, scooter, or anything else with wheels.
And here are some ways that you can take care of your feelings. You could talk to someone you trust about how you're feeling. You can help others. You can observe nature, just get outside. Take care of your pets. Or you could write or draw in a journal.
Those are great ideas. I personally love to read books, walk my dog. Some of you see me walking my dog. Also, I'm learning how to play golf. What about you, Mrs. Kenyon?
I like to take care of myself and find balance by playing games with my family, getting plenty of fresh air and exercise, getting out there every day. And when I'm done with all my work, I like to shut my computer down and charge it for the next day.
Awesome. All right. Our January challenge for all of you is to take care of your mind, your body, and your feeling. Try to unplug from your screens a little bit each day. We're excited to see what you're up to when you're not on your devices. All right, Mr. Brown has a story for us now about a kid named Tech. Tech loves his screen time too much, and he's not very balanced. Find out what it takes to get Tech off of his devices. Enjoy.
Hello, Elmonica, it's Mr. Brown. Today I'm gonna be reading Tech, the Modern Cave Boy by Patrick McDowell. Let's check it out. Once upon a time, way, way back, a long time ago, or maybe yesterday, there lived a little cave boy named Tech. Tech was pretty much your typical troglodyte child. Yes, he did have a beard, but everything was kind of hairy back then. Ugh. All cave boys lived in caves, of course, but the problem with this cave boy was that he never wanted to leave his, even when his friends came to visit. Hi, Tech. Ugh. In the evening, an eerie glow came from Tech's cave, making it impossible to see the twinkling stars above. Beep, boop, bop. Tech stayed alone in his cave room, glued to his phone, his tablet, his game box, all day, all night, all the time. Boop, beep, bop. You should have never invented the internet, Tech's mom grunted to Tech's dad. Beep, bop, bip. Outside, the real world was evolving, but Tech couldn't have cared less. Ugh. Beep, beep. Tech missed out on all the winter fun during the ice age. Boop, bop, beep. He never even learned his dinosaur names, identifying them as whatchamacallitsaurus, who's dadosaurus, or a flying, I don't give a dactyl. The hours, days, and months were slipping by. Boop, bop, beep, 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 bop, beep, boop. My brain may be the size of a walnut, but even I know that is not a healthy situation, said his best friend, Larry. I wish Tech would come out and play. Beep, beep, beep. Thump, thump, thump. Tech's parents tried everything to pry him away from his gadgets, but Tech wouldn't budge. I need to light a fire under that boy's butt, grumbled Tech's dad, except I haven't invented fire yet. Ugh, ugh, ugh. Boop, boop, bop. No one could get Tech's attention. Not even the tribe's Grand Poobah, his high muckety mucks, nor Darla O'Duddy and her dinosaurs for a better tomorrow. All seemed lost until Big Papa, the village volcano, had an idea. He could make fire. He could shake things up. Big time. So Big Papa, beep, 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 popped. The eruption shot Tech and his phone, tablet, and game box out of his cave and into the sky. Tech crashed. He was totally disconnected. Tech awoke, breathing in sweet fresh air, basking in the warm sun, and tickled by the cool grass. He wondered where he was. He looked around and discovered a dragonfly, a tiger lily, a ginkgo tree, a hairy elephant, the hairy people, and awesome, awesome saurus. The big, beautiful world. Sweet. Tech left his gadgets behind and ran to find his good friend, Larry. On the way, kissed his mom and dad. Ugh, groaned his dad. I need to invent shaving cream. Tech and Larry laughed and played all day in that sunny garden. And in the evening, they reached for the glorious stars. The end.
Thanks, Mr. Brown. That was an awesome book. I think in the month of January, I'm going to try to be more balanced and see where I can unplug from my screens and electronics. What are you engineers going to do in January? Do you think that you can live a more balanced lifestyle? I can't wait to see. Anyway, I need all of you guys at home to stand up, get the wiggles out, and let's join Go Noodle for our brain break.
Awesome sauce! Dance, jog, wiggle, or shake to this stellar song!
On 1, 2, 3, y'all shout with me.
Happy Merry Everything!
On 1, 2, 3, y'all shout with me.
Happy Merry Everything!
No matter who you are or what your age, no matter what holiday you celebrate, it's the time of year to bring some cheer to your family, your friends, and your teacher. Yeah. So on 1, 2, 3, y'all shout with me.
Happy Merry Everything!
And on 1, 2, 3, y'all shout with me. Gifts, be grateful, be merry, high five your grandma and your best friend Carrie, or whatever your best friend's name is. Do nice things for the people around you. If a little kid asks, and tie his blue shoe. Enjoy the snow, enjoy the beach, enjoy everything that's in your reach. But don't be greedy. And on 1, 2, 3, y'all shout with me.
Happy Merry Everything!
I said on 1, 2, 3, y'all shout with me. Take a vacation, have a celebration, make a donation, and don't forget hydration. Start a foundation, pet a Dalmatian, give some adoration, make a quotation, spot a constellation, and be a sensation! Now on 1, 2, 3, y'all shout with me.
Happy Merry Everything!
On 1, 2, 3, y'all shout with me.
Happy Merry Everything.
Woo! I don't know about you guys, but that was quite the workout. Thanks, Go Noodle. Your guys' brain breaks get me every time. All right, engineers. Engineers, I want to talk to you guys about an extraordinary opportunity. Did you know that Elmonica had a BIPOC student affinity club? And that Elmonica also hosts a student anti-bias, anti-racist club? Yeah. What is an infinity group? An infinity group is a group of people that share a common experience. Infinity groups can offer special value to those in our community who have had a history and or potential for isolation in the broader community. Affinity groups strengthen the entire Elmonica community by increasing the opportunities for each of us to find support, connection, and a voice at our school. Why is an infinity group space necessary? Well, research on the cognitive development of children show that children begin to develop a sense of their identities as individuals, as members of groups from the earliest ages. Children as young as 3 years old notice the physical differences such as skin color, hair texture, and the shape of facial features. Young children also develop strong in-group preferences. In the school setting, these are early experiences in exploring self-identity and group identity can be isolating and distressing for those children who feel that they are different from most of their peers. What is the impact of affinity spaces? Well-facilitated affinity groups create a positive and constructive context for students to explore and affirm their identities and experiences with the full support of the school, the leadership, and the faculty. This approach helps to strengthen our Elmonica community and to cultivate students' confidence enough in themselves and their place in their community. How cool is that? When asked, why is this necessary? Isn't this segregation? We are really just trying to provide a space for children to have conversations that they feel they need to have. It's not about what we as adults are wanting. Are we going to have affinity groups for white students? Elmonica will also have an affinity club for white students and non-BIPOC students. That club will focus on allyship, addressing the social injustices, and creating an inclusive community for everyone. Sweet! Whose idea was it to have this Infinity Club? It was brought to our attention by the conscientious Elmonica students that requested an Infinity Space. Our student leaders expressed the need to impact Elmonica. They want to see other BIPOC students and BIPOC staff, and they needed a safe place to address these social injustices. Who are the adult facilitators of these Infinity Clubs? It's our BIPOC staff and our BIPOC and white ally staff. So here's the big concept. This is what you need to remember. Elmonica will always strive to cultivate global scholars. That's you! In doing so, we must address and actively dismantle systemic racism. We believe, at Elmonica, in supporting our students, community, and staff. Affinity spaces are a necessary support for this to happen. Remember, education is for improving the lives of others and for leaving your community and world better than you found it. Thank you for the support. We hope and encourage that you take this slideshow as an invitation to get involved. We want to thank our Elmonica parents and community for supporting our students as they advocate for themselves and expand their leadership skills.
Hi, engineers. The Golden Award for Mrs. DeGandy's PE classes goes to Ms. Anderson's fifth grade class. Nice job, Ms. Anderson's class. They won this award because they have been rock stars at showing up to our PE Zoom meetings every week and participating not just in our Zoom activities, but in our Seesaw activities as well. This week, Ms. Anderson's class became the first class to have every single student not just submit a response on their assignment, but have every response approved as well. Nice job, Ms. Anderson's class. Keep being rock stars. You are awesome.
Hello, engineers. This month, I'm giving my golden award for my music classes to a class that's really been doing a great job. They've been attending the Zooms regularly and participating and turning in responses to the work. And it goes to the fourth grade class of Mrs. Stauffer. Great job. Thank you very much.
Hey everyone, for the month of December, the Golden Book Award is going to Ms. Biller's class. Everyone in this class does a great job at staying engaged during library. I can tell that they are excited and ready to read and listen to read aloud. They do their job the entire time. And we have great discussions sometimes before, after, or even during our library specials time. So congratulations, you guys.
Hey, engineers, nice to see you guys. I get to see some of you on Zoom for 30 minutes once a week. That's not very much. Some of you I don't get to see at all, so I miss you guys. Hope to see you soon. Hey, I got to tell you about Miss Valentine's class. I have them on Monday mornings. I'm tired. They're probably tired, but they are ready to go for PE. They have their cameras on. They participate. They're eager learners, so it's awesome. Makes me feel better. Helps me have a better day. So Golden Award goes to Miss Valentine's class. Keep up the good work.
Hi, Elmonica Elementary School. This is Mrs. Heatherly. I'm here to present December's Music Golden Award, and it goes to Mrs. Dodson's kindergarten class. This class has done such an amazing job this year. They have five perfect attendance days. Not one student was absent. They try really hard. They have excellent participation, and I'm really proud of you guys. So congratulations to Ms. Dodson's kindergarten class on your 2020 Golden Award from me, Mrs. Heatherly.
Time. All right, engineers, our time is coming to a close. It's been an awesome first half of the school year, and I can't wait to see what's in store for the year 2021. I hope and wish all of you guys happy holidays, a wonderful winter break, and we'll see you in the new year. This is Mr. Nelson, your student manager, signing off. Take care now.